Hi everybody and welcome back to another episode of Emporium Galactic Survival Alpha 2.0.3, and we've been looking at what we've got. Now we've been trying to decide what to do, and basically there's not much for us to do. Now we can't have any of the clone chambers or the large constructor or the core or anything like that, any of these, until we get some bits and pieces, which was I was trying to do the drones. But we're going to go with the multi-tool because we went to the village. We actually got some bits and pieces, which was quite nice for us. Means we can make a multi-tool. Now the multi-tool is the one that is a remover and stuff, and they've just put it all up together and it upgrade the blocks and stuff like that, so it's like a 3-in-1 gun for the price of one. So we need 4 metal components, okay, 1 electronic, and 1 cable. Okay, now you might not think that is very wise move there, but the multi-tool, you see, I'm going to make the multi-charge 10 metal pieces, going to give us a start. It's going to really be good for us because we can now go around the Crash Titan and we can go and have a look and see what we get. Now we've got all these guns here and stuff like that we don't really technically need. So we've got the multi-tool here. And a multi-tool charge. So if we go onto this multi-tool, because we have a light with a multi-tool, and we click R to reload it, we can now go along and we can see, well, what can we do? What is there that that there is that we can get? Now remember, you've got to be careful when you take this base apart, okay, because it will drop, it will degrade, so they say it will come apart. That's what you've got to be careful of. So if you are going to be doing this, make sure you work from top to bottom. While we're doing a little bit of support here, but we're going to be going out of here shortly. So now that, you see, is valuable to us. This is why looking for cargo and stuff like that on a ship is always worth it. It just saves you bits and pieces, time and effort and mining and all that sort of stuff. So we've got quite a few bits and pieces there. Not sure what's in the top here. Always good to look around. Looking for some lights. The reason I'm looking for some lights is because we get electronics. Now these doors will come in very, very handy. So we've got a rocket drone there. So we don't want to attract his attention too much. We probably already have, that's why he's over here. Too much to me. Now I know there was one that was up here. Let's go around and have a look. found two, didn't we? So we got quite a bit from there. So we can shove all of these. So, let's see what we've got now. So this is going to be the first bit. So metal components, we can now see that you've got red and green. So in the green you've got 4, you need 5, you need 3 electronics. You still need 5 computers, so that's one that we're going to be working on. Computers here. Control device, only 1. Cable, so we need 2. So if we make another cable, and then we've got our first computer. We haven't really gone and done much. As you can see, there's not that much room in here. So what is next? So we've got another cable. Of electronics. So hopefully we can get the core of the base going. So we've got 2 computers, cables 1, metal components 2. So this is the last one, metal components, cables, electronics, and then we can move to the core. Right, so there's the computer. So we want 5 metal components. Four electronics. Make too much of something, turn off your 3 cables. Now we've got the core. That's our most important thing. And this is what we're making here, which is a base starter. Now this, ladies and gentlemen, is going to be where we decide where we put our base, because this is where we're going. This is, like I said, this is our base. Is going to be the core part, and we're going to have to protect it and everything like that. So we are going to have it next to the Titan. I don't think we can have it in the Titan, because you can't make the Titan into a base, because you're floating up and down on it. So we're going to start, I don't know, might as well start here. Okay, now what I want to do with that core is protect it. And the way that we're going to be doing that, these are hardened steel blocks, these are steel blocks, these are concrete blocks. No, I never used concrete blocks before. That's got hit points 40, 50 and 200. So we are going to use iron blocks. So like I said, this is our core, and that's it. We're protecting our core there, because when you're on your base, you press P, yeah, and your core is there. You can turn it on and off. Okay. What we're going to do now, concrete blocks. Different design to what I was going to be doing last time. Okay. And then we've got steel blocks. So I want my core well protected. So currently that's the going to be the core. So that's like, that's 1, 2, 3. So I really want them to work at it to get to this core. So that's going to be the core defence. So we're going to have I got the got my chainsaw on me? I don't think I have. There we go. Start getting bait. That bit good, wasn't it? I upgraded that one, but I don't know what that one's upgraded to. I think that's upgraded to... I'm the upgrade tool there as well. Got some damage here, but we found some boxes. All cool stuff. Do we've got any wood? Yeah, we have got wood, so right, concrete blocks. I wonder if we can upgrade with us. Cement. I wonder. Because that would be quite cool. We could do that. So it's shift. Whoops, wrong one. That's nice to know, isn't it? So we can actually have some nice, good, decent stuff. So that's a cement block, isn't it? Cool, so we now know how to upgrade. So, let's so. Like I say, I'm putting my cube, my core. Nice big protected area. I mean, you don't have to do this, but if you don't want your base blown up, I suggest you do it. Yourself more. Thank you. biofuel, didn't we? I do love the idea that we can upgrade the blocks. Thank you. Now don't forget, we will be making this into a capital ship eventually. I'll know how to. So I'm going to leave a wooden base. So it gives you back the blocks when you upgrade them, so that's good, quite interesting there. Only thing with this game is when it's dark, it gets dark, which is nice, to be honest. I've seen so many games that where you play them, it's just, you know, absolutely horrendous. Because you can see in the dark. You shouldn't be able to see in the dark. Dark is dark. There's no lights, nothing like that. Only the stars. Now you might think this is a bit excessive, but we are on the hard mode. But this is what I mean. It's nice here. I should really go out and get some food. But it is night time. I think shortly we will have to start going and looking for food. I know you guys can't see this very well. Just one of those things for us. cannot see anymore. Well, since we can't bloody well see anyway, so we're on level 5 now. We're just gonna have to go and find some food. We've got a thing in a gun, yeah. Okay, I don't like shooting these geezers. Food on them. Okay, you have food poisoning. What have we got food poisoning for? Because we had too much of the same thing. That's new. Who knows, we got that. We'll make a med kit in a minute. So because we've got food poisoning, we'll have to go and deal with that. Because now we can't run. Okay, so a bandage is a small med kit. Okay, so applying a small med kit, I think. As long as you do a full lot, a full bar, it gets rid of the food poisoning. Okay, so we've got got antidote pills. Stomach pills. There we go, I have those there. So we're going to leave it there for today, ladies and gentlemen, and we will get back and carry on continuing our base. Have fun, stay safe. Bye for now.